So let's do Python 2.7 next. So I'm not going to bother with any of the optional installations because I'm only installing Python 2 purely because it's required for something else. It's not something, because it's not supported anymore, it's not something I'd willingly want to run. So let's get this one installed then. I'll go back. Oh, I like the right window. Go back. Python 2.7. Bear in mind, as I said before, it's not being supported. It hasn't been supported for almost 2 years now. Now, whether there are any security updates, like third-party ones being updated, I don't know. But as it says here, it's been deprecated by the developers upstream, and support was discontinued. Didn't mention anything about any security support. It sounds like it's completely been abandoned now. So let's download the package. And yeah, there's a patch here for security fixes. So whether they're patches that the LFS team have created, or if they're third-party ones, or indeed if they are have actually come from the people who did Python developers, I don't know. And some documentation here which we can install. Okay, so I'll extract the package. And so let's check to see what options there are. So system expert, I imagine these would be already in the setup. Yes, they are. This is for a short pip. Okay, not particularly bothered about those. So I'll accept the default build instructions and wait a few minutes for this to be installed. Right, that's finished compiling. So now I'm going to run the tests. It does actually say that it runs through tests twice for some reason. So if we see that happening, we'll know that's expected. Okay, so that has passed, all successful, so I'm going to install it now. With these commands here. Now while it's installing, it says here that because, well, it says Python 2 is in maintenance mode, clearly it's not. If it's deprecated, I can't see why they're maintaining it. Python 3 is recommended for upstream development, so you probably don't need to install the documentation. That's a fair comment. So because of that, although I've actually downloaded the documentation, I'm not going to bother to install it because it seems not to make sense to do that for something that's not supported anymore. So that looks like it's completed. Just an export there for the documentation. So yes, that is done.